Nic, with the loss of Richard Holbrooke now, what kind of void will this leave in the region?
It's going to leave a very big void. He filled a big space here, and he played a big role bringing together the United States position on Afghanistan and Pakistan and bringing both those countries together. He was last here late October, and the results of some of his efforts were seen here just a few weeks ago when President Karzai hosted a meeting with Pakistani Prime Minister Gilani. This was as much a result of Richard Holbrooke's efforts and vision to bring these two countries into alignment and to develop common cause and common strategy against the Taliban and both their challenges. That was the fruits of his work. But what we're hearing from Afghan officials today, from the president's office, saying that this is a sad loss for Afghanistan, that he was a key and big figure in helping define and refine the United States strategy, not just here in Afghanistan, but throughout the region. Senior politicians from the government as well have been weighing in, also saying that Richard Holbrooke's passing is a huge loss here. There's no doubt that however tough his diplomatic position here might have been, he was certainly recognized as somebody who was working for the interests of Afghanistan and working for a better situation here for everyone. And that's being keenly felt. And just talking to Afghans this morning, they feel the same way. They know that this was a man who was working for them and for their country. And they feel that he is going to be sadly missed.
Nic, Richard Holbrooke was known as a very, very tough negotiator. And his relationship with President Karzai has had some very big bumps in the road. Describe how that relationship worked.
Well, similarly with his relationship with President Zardari in neighboring Pakistan, Richard Holbrooke, a consummate diplomat, incredibly tough. It was really his ability to stand up to the bullying tactics of the Balkan politicians that brought an end to the Dayton War, brought an end to the Bosnia War with the Dayton Peace Accords, and allowed him to stand up to Slobodan Milosevic in 1999, essentially giving him the demarche that unless he changed his position on Kosovo, then there would be NATO bombardments of Serbia. And that's indeed what happened. It was a very tough style of diplomacy that he exercised when he came here to this region. He learned, and the people around him, the diplomats around him, watched and listened as he learned how hard he was going to have to study to learn things on the ground here. Afghans, Pakistanis like to do things here through many long conversations over many cups of tea, meetings that can often have no apparent conclusion, really a forum for people to air opinions. Richard Holbrooke's agenda and his needs and the United States' needs here needed resolutions to those issues that were often part of endless discussions. He needed to force the issues, and he needed to tell some home truths, and there were a lot of home truths to be told here. The United States is absolutely sick and tired of the corruption here, and that was a message that he had to deliver face-to-face to President Karzai. So those kinds of messages delivered in his diplomatic style, not over endless conversations, without fruition, were the tough points of that relationship.